Communism reached its peak in the 1960s. The Soviet Union and the East run by the communist regime in Moscow. In China, and his ideology was portrayed as an infallible guide. Fidel Castro ruled in Cuba. Communist guerrilla leader Che Guevara was attempting to organize guerrilla wars in the country of Bolivia. Many other countries in Africa, Latin America, and Asia were under the threat of communist terrorist organizations or communist regimes. During those years, communists also broke onto the scene in a totally unexpected place. Marxist ideology began to spread rapidly among young people in the West. The Marxist thinker Herbert Marcuse played an important role in the phenomenon. Offered a new definition of class. That same Marcuse actually agreed with Lenin and Mao on one fundamental matter. That was the Darwinist dogma that conflict was the fundamental law of nature. Marcuse's belief in conflict turned the 68 generation out onto the streets. People held protest rallies at which they shouted slogans in support of North Vietnamese leader Ho Chi Minh. In Italy, leftist groups carried out acts of terrorism. The greatest violence in 1968 was in France. Lastly, Marxists in Paris occupied their universities. Socialist slogans were shouted during the celebration. Events began to grow as other leftists organized marches in support of the students. Marxist students tore cars apart and smashed streets and shops. In a matter of a few days, it turned into a barbarity that marched under the red flag was only later. In 1968, student incidents spread to many other countries under a kind of domino effect, and each time they led to social conflict, acts of terrorism, and even civil war. Those young people, exasperated by the political and economic problems of their day, believed that communism offered a solution. The education system were a proven scientific fact. Young people We may recall that Darwin's theory of evolution The entire picture reveals a worldview that regards man as a species of animal and believes that he Communism will inevitably ensue. When it finds an appropriate climate, communism reorganizes itself and again begins shedding blood. The fact that the communist regimes in the Soviet Union and the Eastern Communism is still a threat to the world, because the ideology's basic philosophy is still alive and well. As long as that basis, in other words, Darwinism and materialism is still alive, communism will continue to represent a grave menace to mankind. That being the case, the solution lies in doing away with that philosophical foundation. Darwinism and materialist philosophy in any case possess no scientific basis and must no longer be imposed on society as who must live by the lights of that morality created and revealed by God. Once that truth has been grasped, both communism and the other ideologies that have brought disaster to mankind will disappear, and man will live in peace, security, and brotherhood.